Hey guys, before we begin the video, I want to quickly congratulate the winner of today's Twitter giveaway, who's receiving the pair of Elite Lockjaw clamps. The next Lockjaw giveaway will have three different pairs, aka three different winners. So I'm trying to give more people a chance to win. It's going to be pretty awesome. Wanted to give you guys a quick heads up ahead of time that this Wednesday, the 13th, I'm going to be doing a big Isatori giveaway on Twitter again, where I'll be giving away Isatori's pre-workout pre-grow and their DA3 Isatest, the natural test booster that they have. Both of those. I'm going to be giving those away. All you have to do is be following Isatori. That's one of the rules that Isatori agreed to. And in return, they're going to donate two of those products, and I'm going to send them out to you guys. So Wednesday, look out for my tweet. It's going to have a picture of the Isatori product. It's going to say, retweet to win. Click that retweet button, and I'll be picking the winner at random, like always. So, see you there. Follow me at Nick Wright, NWB on Twitter. This is just my way of giving back to you guys for all the amazing support you've given me over the years. Enjoy the rest of the video. How cool is this shirt right here? Saiyan Army in shiny golden black. This is my boy Matt Keto. Remember Goku Flex on YouTube? He made this shirt. He actually collaborated with Alpha Clothing to make this shirt. So it's sold out pretty fast. I think there's a couple of XLs left and that's it. I take a large personally. And I think he's going to be restocking soon. So you can follow him, Goku Flex, on YouTube for like updates on the restock. But they do sell it on Alpha's website, which is in the info box below too. So I think it's pretty cool. Saiyan Army. Making a music video. New weekend song out. It's not the weekend song, but it has the weekend in it, so I have to update you. It's Might Not by Belly. Featuring the weekend.
Okay.
Belly. Belly.
Belly? Really? Belly. That's the name?
Yeah, that's one of the, but yeah, that's out. Might Not. The verse sounds really cool and the chorus sounds really cool. You guys want to see what I do with my thumbnails? Take a raw photo like this. And see that little clarity button right there? You can't see it because this won't focus. That little button, clarity. Hit that. Boom. Just amplifies the lighting, makes it more vibrant. Simple as that. If anything is too dark, it makes it brighter. And then I use that for a thumbnail. Do not use Photoshop. And every YouTuber edits their thumbnails. In fact, I got my app ideas for photo editing from Max Tuning and Christian Guzman. Anyway, I'm going to tweet this photo to y'all right now. I love chatting with y'all on Twitter. Hang on, ready? What can I put? What can I put? Good morning! Exclamation point. And I tweet that. Love hearing from y'all on Twitter. I should probably specify that this is down to half a cup of oatmeal now because my calories are dropped for today. So half a cup of oatmeal, 2 tablespoons of the peanut butter. By the way, love all the photos you guys have been tweeting me of the honey roasted peanut butter. Hilarious. And I put one packet of Splenda in there. It tastes really good. And then this is 2 scoops of Eat Smart with Cool Whip. The light Cool Whip, or fat-free Cool Whip. How's this for a throwback? The OG of all energy drinks, the pioneer of energy drinks, the one who started it all, Red Bull. I used to drink this back in the day and on my first job dishwashing, like 13, 14 years old. We used to have a store connected to the restaurant and I'd run over and grab one of these like every day. Memories. Anyway, I got this because I don't want a lot of caffeine right now, but I need a little pick-me-up for the day. Typically on days that I train, I never take energy drinks, coffee, nothing, because I end up having pre-workout. So I don't want to combine pre-workout and another source of caffeine. It's one or the other. So off days, I'll do my energy drinks or my coffee. On days, I'll do just the pre-workout. But today, I'm training late, and I can't make it that long. So this is only 80 milligrams of caffeine and no calories.
His axe was now covered in blood. The first thought that came up was, whose or what's blood?
Yeah, listen to creepy pastas when I drive on YouTube sometimes. What of it? They're awesome. Red Bull's never been great taste-wise compared to Monster and Rockstar. But the Total Zero,
is absolutely horrible, like even for Red Bulls. I personally don't mind Red Bull's taste if I'm like readying myself for Red Bull. If you drink it expecting it to be like Monster, it's just got awful. Because Monster does taste great. But yeah, the Total Zero Red Bull, that's awful even by Red Bull standards.
What are you doing, Lucy? Curiosity killed the dog, you know. Ooh, the old gym. Oh, wow, dude. Remember this barbell? This was like my barbell. This is the barbell I did everything with. All my old bench PRs when I first started training. Anything I ever did down here weightlifting-wise was done with this barbell. It's such a crappy barbell. It's all bent and lopsided now and no good, but man, that was the barbell. Oh, the old trophies. You can tell I keep my bodybuilding accolades in very high esteem. All my old trophies shoved back here. Man, I just got some crazy nostalgic memories. Just a huge flashback from my childhood. In my childhood, I mean teenhood. Remember this mirror? Alright, anyway, back to business. So I'm down here in the old workshop, my father's workshop. We're at my parents' house, by the way, in case you didn't pick that up yet. seeing if I can scrap together a 2-inch board for board pressing without having to go to Home Depot. I'm going to show you guys what board pressing is and what it's for in a minute. But yeah, basically I got to make a 2-inch board for board pressing. There's all different sizes. You can make them pretty fancy, but because board pressing is not something I do regularly, it's not the most necessary thing for raw lifters, though it can be beneficial if you incorporate it the right way, as I'm going to show you. I don't feel the need to go and make a fancy one, so I just want to really just scrap something together that's 2 inches thick that I can use for 2-inch board pressing. And if I can avoid going to Home Depot or spending any money on it, then why not? We got a lot of scrap wood here. Do any of you remember my old system I had on my Honda Civic back when I was like 17? When I used to do custom car audio, this was the little amp wall. It was like an amp rack, but it was set up in my car like a little wall. And that was where I had my little amplifier hooked up. Wow. Anyway, I found these two pieces. They'll work. Pre-drilled them so there's no splitting in the wood. And now we're going to insert the actual screws in there. Make it nice and sturdy like Bob the Builder. Alright, mate, that's what we have here. It's pretty much done. Alright, it is downright hideous. It's dashingly ugly. It's disgustingly, I ran out of vocabulary words. Abhorrent. There you go. There's one. Anyway, I wrapped it in tape, just the 2-inch thick part. Mostly just to keep splinters out of the picture, in all honesty, because the tape doesn't look much prettier. And as you can see, it is exactly 2 inches on the dot. So everybody, without further ado, I'd like you to meet Plank. Plank is my new training partner. Plank is going to help me get my bench press way up. You can sit in the back seat, Plank.
Hey, what are we about to do? We're going to bench press a lot of weight. Yeah.
Any jawbreakers, Plank?
Plank-a-tree.
25.
So today we're doing the board press, something brand spanking new to me. I've never done it in my life. It's not the most common exercise for raw lifters. A lot of the West Side guys will do it, and equipped lifters will do it, but they usually do it with a lot thicker boards, really working their lockout and whatnot. The fact that it's 2 inches makes it so it still gives you a lot of good carryover as a raw bencher. What we're gonna do, you'll see it in a second, is I called my friend Ming over here, who graciously came down to meet Ricky and I at the gym, because you need 3 people to do board pressing. You need someone to hold the board and then somebody to give you a lift off. Basically, you're gonna have somebody hold the board over your chest. We're gonna lower the bar down until it touches the board. You can do a slight pause, but just enough to keep it controlled. You don't have to do a full on rest pause. And what the board's gonna do is basically take 2 inches out of your range of motion, making it a little bit easier since it's less range of motion. And if it's easier, you might be able to do a little bit more weight, make it for better overload of your lockout. But because it's only 2 inches, you're still going down a lot further than you would on even a floor press, so you're still gonna get a lot of the motion in there. So the fact that you're taking the very bottom stretch reflex out of it might make it even harder. Kind of a gamble, you just kinda gotta find out how it feels. But either way, it's great for overload, it's great for really training that control launch off the bottom without getting that stretch reflex and the elastic tension. So I'm excited for it. Tilt it down. There you go. You can also see how everyone's kissing it.
Yeah.
In the future, you probably have a little bit more of that.
We're in plain time.
One, two, got it. Easy weight. Warm up weight, come on. Control that shit. Push it up. Push that up. Push, push, push. Ah! Hit that
plank.
Hit that peg a little bit. You were good. All right.
Ready?
We good.
Same focus. Ready? One, two, up.
Got it.
I don't know why it does that shit. I feel like it's just heavier.
It could go either way because.
Got it. Dang.
Woo! That felt easy.
One, two,
Got it.
Push! Come on!
Woo!
That was easy.
That felt good.
That was easy.
What's up, Nick?
What's up, brother? How you been?
Tell someone.
All right, so we finished out with 345. Felt really, really good. It felt really easy. So I'm gonna cut it there to make sure I leave off on a very clean, moderately fast note, and break down 80% of that, which is 275, and bang out my three sets of five working sets now. So very happy with how 345 felt. Felt very controlled. Felt awesome.
One, two,
Feel how you lose that bottom pop, so it's a little bit more challenging, but it feels good.
So after working up to a heavy single and performing three sets of five reps with the board, I then just did one regular set of 275, paused as many reps as I could with the fatigue.
Anything out
there.
Yeah,
yeah, I got
you. So, six, we'll call it a six. I feel like dick.
Reason number two why I like this house. You saw the first one on Twitter if you follow me. I can successfully play Halo while handling my business at the same time. Just did it now. Ariana was on the couch, didn't even realize it. Didn't even notice my mischievous activities.
No, I was so enthralled in what I was reading on the internet.
Success.